In order to succeed, you must first believe that you can. Welcome to the video session of MahendraGuru.com. This topic that we have today is the session layer, the protocols associated with the session layer. The previous VDP was on the topic session layer, and today's VDP, today's session is on the protocols that are associated with the session layer, the layer 5 of the OSI model. Let's have a view on the 7-layer architecture of OSI model and see where actually the session layer is located or positioned. So, the first layer that we have here is the physical layer, the data link layer, the second layer, the network layer, the third layer, the transport layer, the fourth layer, the session layer, the fifth layer, topic for today, and the presentation layer, the sixth layer, and finally we have the application layer, the seventh layer of the OSI model. The reason behind showing this figure in each and every VDP is to make you memorize this figure, and a fact that we have to follow the bottom top approach, the first, the second, the third, and so on. Now here we have a pictorial representation of the session layer. Now the session layer is located below the presentation layer or above the transport layer, or we can say in between the presentation as well as the transport layer. Now let us see what all protocols are associated with the session layer, the layer 5 of the OSI model. The protocols that are associated with the session layer are, first of all, the definition that we have. The session layer, the layer 5 of the OSI model, acts very similar to its name. We all know why the session layer, is given such a name. It establishes a session. Now the reason, it establishes a session between the source and the destination. Establishing a session, managing a session, and demolishing a session are three services that are provided by this layer. The protocols associated with this layer are, now the main topic, the main point, the protocols that are associated with this layer. Now, the protocols might be a typical one, you must have not heard their name, but are very important one if we consider establishing a session. The first protocol that we have is the SAP, session announcement protocol, SAP. It is a programming language, it's a programming concept, it's a network protocol. In this case, SAP is our network protocol, session announcement protocol. Now what does a session announcement protocol or a SAP does? As a protocol that operates on the session layer, very true, we all know. The main function of the SAP is, now the main function of the SAP, the main function of the SAP is to broadcast. To broadcast what? To broadcast the information of multicast session. Now what is a multicast session? A multicast session demonstrates one to many connections or many to many connections. Now the calling with the definition of SAP. SAP is used to broadcast the information of multicast session using what? This is a third point to be remembered, using or taking a help of session description protocol, very often known as SDP. These three points are to be memorized by each and every aspirant of SOIT and PU. Multicast sessions information is broadcasted by SAP using the or taking the help of SDP, session description protocol. Moving over to the next protocol that we have in the session layer. The session layer consists of the second protocol, the very important one, SOCKS. Socket secure. Now what is the function of SOCKS? Socket secure, the function of SOCKS is a simple one. Yes, it is. It exchanges the network packet. What does it exchanges? It exchanges the network packet. Network packet between whom and whom? Between the client system and the associated server. Between the client and the server. A system that requests is a client, and a system that fulfills the request by the client is a server. We all know what a client and server architecture is. The SOCKS transmits or exchanges rather the network packet between the client system and the associated server. Now a single point that we have that we can see here in the SOCKS, and the second point that we can see is that it makes the use of a proxy server. Now what is a proxy server? A proxy server is actually a server that is placed in between the client and the actual server. Proxy server is many times used as a packet or data filter or a control filter node too. It can be used for any of these three functions. It can also be used as a filter of filter of what? Filter of exchange of data. Now, moving over to the next protocol that we have, PPTP. PPTP, point-to-point tunneling protocol. Now, what is point-to-point tunneling protocol? We must have heard about PPP, point-to-point protocol. Now, point-to-point tunneling protocol. Tunnel. Tunnel is actually a limited area that is a bounded area that is actually used to what? That is actually used to limit the flow of data, the flow of current, and in real life, it is used to limit the flow of traffic. That traffic can be human traffic, that traffic can be of any of the objects available in the real world. Now, here the tunnel is used to establish a what? Here the tunnel is used to establish a VPN. Now, what is a VPN? VPN is a virtual private network. Virtual private network that is used to define a network over what? That is used to define a network over the public network. A network that is established over a public network, pretending as if the connection is established over a private network. With the help of a VPN, we can send the data in a secured form, we can send the data in an effective and efficient format, and we can rely on the VPN whenever we talk about a public network. VPN is a virtual private network established on a public network. Now, for doing so, we take help of the PPTP, point-to-point tunneling protocol. Let's see what next do we have in this protocol series of session layer. The next protocol that we have is the RTP, a real-time transport protocol. Now, what is real-time transport protocol? Does real-time in computers makes any sense? Yes, it does. Real-time is a very important concept if we consider the networking or we consider the offline computer scenarios. It is a very useful protocol as it is used to deliver audio and video. Now, what all contents are delivered by the RTP? The first content that we can see here is the audio, and the second content is the video data. And one thing that is not mentioned here, it is used to deliver audio, it is used to deliver video, and is also used for multimedia streaming. The first point used to deliver audio and video, and the second point that it delivers audio and video over the IP network. This is the second point that should be memorized, over the IP network. Audio and video are delivered by the RTP over an IP network. Now, the services provided by the RTP. Video teleconference, we all must have encountered this. We all must have someday or the other used video conferencing. Telephony and web push-to-talk. Push-to-talk was a concept of first generation of telecommunication. Now, we have a new concept which is based on web push-to-talk. These all three services are provided by the RTP, the real-time transport protocol, one of the most important protocol of the session layer. Now, moving over to the next slide, let's see what we have. We have here the questionnaire round. Now, let's see what all questions are asked here. Name the layer number that is used to demolish a session. Now, we all know dash is a layer that is used to create, manage, and demolish a session. And the name of the layer is the session layer, the topic for today. The session layer is used to create, manage, and demolish a session. Now, here the name is not asked. They are asking the number on which this layer is located or positioned. Now, let us recall the seven-layer architecture of OSI. The first layer we have is the physical layer. The second layer, data link layer. The third layer, network layer. The fourth layer, the transport layer. And the fifth layer is the session layer. So the answer is yes. The answer is session layer that is located on the fifth number of the OSI model. Let's see. Yes. Session layer, layer 5 of the OSI model. Now, moving over to the next question. Dash protocol is used to establish a VPN. Now, name the protocol that is used to establish a VPN, a virtual private network. Yes, we all studied, a few minutes back, we have studied that protocol. Dash is a protocol used to establish a VPN. That protocol consists of a word tunneling or tunnel. Yes, exactly. The name of the protocol is PPTP, point-to-point tunneling protocol, PPTP, one of the most important protocol of the session layer. Moving over to the next question. Okay, now we have the question that says the session announcement protocol, the SAP, operates with which protocol? The very first protocol that you studied in this video session. The SAP operates with which protocol? Or the SAP takes the help or seeks the help of which protocol to broadcast the information of multicast session? Yes, the answer is session description protocol. Let's see. Yes, session description protocol is the answer here. Moving over to the last question that we have. Protocol used to deliver audio and video over an IP network. We have studied the last protocol that is used to deliver audio and video over an IP network. Yes, it was somewhat like real-time. Yes, it was real-time transport protocol, the RTP protocol of the session layer. So the next Digi Page will be on the presentation layer, the layer 6 of the OSI model. Thank you for being a part of this video session. Do comment us, do meet us on mahendraguru.com, and please do subscribe us on our and yours YouTube channel, www.youtube.com/c/MahendraGuru videos. Your success is our success. Thank you.